In this video, I would like to show you how you can work with the web server and how you will upload your files. If you look at the address bar, you will see the address of the web server. CAWT web is what's called a subdomain. It is a section of the server. You will be typing in the address to your account in order to see your files. So I will type in mine. My address will be different from yours because yours has your ID and mine has my last name. We have a folder location somewhere on this web server. It doesn't matter where that folder is. It doesn't matter what the name of that folder is. That is your root folder. That is the starting point for all of your files. And whenever you type in a web address, it will automatically take you to a folder and it will launch what is called the default file. In this case, we have an index.html default file. Index.html is the most common name for the home page. Now, it does have some directions here. It says access the check.php file for information. So if I were to type in that file name and hit the enter key, I will get some information here. And it tells me what my IP address is, and I can hit the back button. Every account will start out with a test file. What you will need to do is to delete it and replace it with your own index file. Should you wish to keep this file here, all you need to do is rename it. Index.html will automatically load. So let's take a look at how you should be organizing your files and folders. Here I have a sample on my hard drive. Notice on the left-hand side, I have underscore CAWT170. The reason I have an underscore there is it forces this folder to be the first one there. This is my root. Everything in this folder I will be placing on the web server. That means that all my paths, all my links need to work correctly, and I need to upload everything exactly as it is on my own hard drive in order for it to work correctly on the web server. I only have one folder to start with, Chapter 2. However, in the root, now remember, this is the root. This is the submission template. That is the template that you will be given. And what you want to do is you want to rename that. And I will rename that once I get it on the server. This is what this submission template looks like. And what you will do with this file, you will put your name here, and you will also put your ID there. And you will create hyperlinks to the FTP site and to the server. You will have absolute links. The links will start with FTP and HTTP. Now here, I just have a layout. I only have a link to one file so far, and I will show you how to do the rest. So this is a template for what we will need in this class. If I click on the link to my exercise file for Chapter 2, and this is just a sample page, this is not the assignment. And if I click the back button, I go back. So you will need to open your editor, and you will need to write the paths in. So you will be placing your Chapter 2 assignments in a Chapter 2 folder on the web server, in an exercises folder, which is inside Chapter 2, and then the actual file name. That is your path. And then this is the hyperlink. And you can call that exercise, you can write the file name, you can call that whatever you want. You will also need to upload your assignment. So for every chapter, you will have an exercise folder and an assignment folder. So I will put a break tag here, and now I will start to code in the link. Notice, this is my submission template, which will be renamed as index.html. This is in my root. All of my links are going down. So I will go down into Chapter 2. Notice how smart my editor is. I will go into the assignments folder, and notice there are four files. This is for Java Jam. And I will select index.html, and now I can just type in whatever I want. If I save this and load, there we are. Notice my links work. So you want to be testing everything before you upload it to the server, and you also want to test everything after you upload to the server. let's take a look at my folder layout. Here again, whatever you want to call it, this is your root. This is going to be your index file. That's your template. Here's chapter 2. In chapter 2, I have an assignments folder and an exercises folder. In assignments, I have my 4 files for Java Jam. When I go back, I go into exercise, there's my chapter 2. So this folder structure, these 2 folders are in my chapter 2 folder, which is in my root. We have to replicate that on the web server. We do it using an FTP client. There are many FTP clients out there. A very good choice is the Fire FTP add-on for the Firefox browser. So we need to type in the host. The host is cawtweb.canyons.edu. My username, your username is different. My username is 170-Pelkie. Yours will be 170-your ID. And then the password. Please do not share your user ID with anyone because they might be able to access your account and steal your assignments. Please do not share passwords with anyone. It will be port 21. That may already be there. You have a handout explaining all this. I click the connect. You will see things happening. These are the default files that are already there when we opened up our website. So let me go back and show you. Here we are. This is the default index.html. And remember, we looked at the check PHP. So when you upload, you should also be checking in the browser to make sure that everything looks right. Because what happens in the FTP happens automatically in the browser. What I'm going to do, I'm going to rename this. So if I right-click, I can rename. The way that you rename might be different in different programs. Just in case, on the left-hand side, I'm going to access my files. So I'll go to my documents. There's my CAWT. There's the submission template. On the left-hand side, this is the root on my hard drive. On the right-hand side, this is the root on my server. And you can just drag and drop. Now I'm going to rename this. This will be index.html. The first thing I'm going to do is to test. And there I am. Notice this is on the web. Every time you upload files, access your web address in a browser and check. Because if you do something wrong and you don't check it, you're going to be losing points. Now we need to create a folder. This is my root. I have a chapter 2 folder. Therefore, I need a chapter 2 folder over here. So I can right click and I can choose new folder. Remember, the tools might be different depending on the FTP application you're using. Please use lowercase. It makes things easier. No spaces. Now I have a chapter 2 folder. It's on my hard drive. It's on my server. If I double click into my chapter 2 folder, I have assignments and exercises. I need to create an assignment folder and an exercise folder. Right click, new folder, assignments. Right click, new folder, exercises. If I double click into the assignments folder, there's my files, and I can move them all over at once. There we are. Now I need to go up and notice I have a little icon there. Now I will go into my exercises folder. I will reload. Here's the Java Jam assignment. I click. Notice chapter 2, assignments, and there's index. And when I click on another file, it will show me the file name. Websites have thousands of files and they have an organization. My root over in my hard drive, my root on the server. So for the following chapters, you will be repeating the same procedure and you will be uploading that folder structure to the web.